this is Steve Cardenas, Rocky the Red Ranger, and you're listening to Ranger Recap.
Okay, so time for another round of this. Hey, Easy, how you doing after Paramorphicon Express?
I'm fine.
That's good, good. Hopefully you got some energy left. Yeah, hopefully you'll have some energy left. Wait, what the? Who the hell's knocking on our door?
Well, you didn't think you could do this show without me now, did you guys?
Oh, son of a bitch.
Oh, yeah.
Aha, my deus ex is right on time.
Oh, well, hit that beautiful intro. Let's get it going.
Let's do it.
Well, here comes the Rangers.
Everyone, and welcome back to the Ranger Recap, the only Power Rangers podcast to ask the question, have you had your Morphex today? Because I know I have.
Ah!
Nice.
Yeah, I'm just over here playing with the spoils of war. Seriously, if you haven't gone to our Facebook page yet, you'll see what we mean.
Oh, yeah.
Indeed, indeed.
But we'll get to that.
Yeah.
Anyway, time for your introduction.
Yep. I am your friendly neighborhood Easy Rider, your Power Morphicon congoer extraordinaire. And over here, that's the Shades. We still need to pop his Morphicon cherry someday. We will.
One day.
And over there, that's Matty J. He's been doing Morphicon or one.
We'll make it two next year just so we can save Morphicon or two.
Yep. I can't tell you this one. I can't tell you this before we get started. No lines. Well, none for us anyway. At least it wasn't line. It wasn't line apocalypse like it was last year.
Line con. That's what it was.
But of course, as you heard, we are not alone here tonight, since we had someone else joining Easy at Power Morphicon Express. It's here. We felt it was only fitting to have him on tonight's stream. So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome from the Anime Mavericks Podcast, good old Mike Schell.
Hey, everybody. Yes, your friendly neighborhood Fezhead is here again as well. And yes, Power Morphicon Express was awesome.
Yeah, believe it or not, Mike's got more stories to tell than I do.
Well,
that's a first.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. In fact, actually, I need to do one little thing real quick before we get into this.
Don't mind me. Just playing with my new toy.
You know, it's funny, before we actually get to that real quick, I did recheck my local Toys R Us, which have been the franchise up in Canada, the company in Canada, which is still which is separate from the, well, you get the idea. They've been advertising them toys, and them toys did indeed show up. You remember that picture of that shelf, Easy John, pretty much everybody. You remember that picture I said when I would an empty shelf with like a half open Legacy Xenizer?
Yeah.
It's full now.
Damn. Ooh.
One of them toys.
Nice.
$40 though, so I'm like, I gotta wait just a tad.
Yeah.
Why don't you come to the States?
little cheaper, huh?
Definitely. Now, before we get into more the Pyromorphicon stories, because we will get to that, we're gonna spend quite a bit of time on that. I do have one little bit of news that I want to kind of run out of the way so we can get that done and over. So we're gonna talk a little bit about that. Because there has been a recent announcement from Shout Factory.
Yay! Wait, what?
Yes. I double-checked the news this morning, and there has been a new announcement from Shout Factory for Power Rangers. This is not a Sentai DVD, but it is a classic Power Rangers production that I think you guys might be interested in. All I'm going to say is that it is time to shift into Turbo.
They got the movie.
Turbo, a Power Rangers movie, is coming soon to Blu-ray, courtesy of Shout Factory.
And they get it in too.
Sweet. Yes.
Very nice.
First, you were able to experience Ivan Ooze's great one-liners in HD. Now you get to experience Divatox's boobs in HD. Yay! Oh, come on. Why else would you watch that movie? Oh, yeah, I guess there are some Power Rangers in there, too.
Well, let's put it this way. Tits. Why not?
Actually, one of my favorite things was I heard this in a Phoenix Rock skit. D cups full of justice. Sweet.
I remember that from C Lab.
That's D cups where it of came justice. From. Yeah.
Sweet. Hey, that's my battle cry. Sweet.
That's probably where the audio came from.
Yep, probably. Yep, and D cups of justice, aka an Adrian Barbobot, right, Mike?
All right. So enough about that. But yes, Turbo Power Rangers movie coming to Blu-ray. Hopefully, some of you guys will probably pick that up. But let's get to the big topic of the day. Before we get to the episode, of course, Power Morphicon Express happening in Pasadena, Texas, at the Pasadena Convention Center. Hopefully you
Why are you reading this off like it's a wrestling card?
Because I'm copying you.
Well, at least he's honest about it.
You are a very good man for doing that. I appreciate that. That's nice.
Turned that one right around on you, didn't I?
From you! I got it from watching you!
Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Schell. He doesn't speak often, but when he does, you will hear him.
That's what I had to put up with all weekend.
That must have been some good riffing when you guys were watching that Joe Bob Briggs show.
Oh boy. Boy, we got a movie to show you two when we come back.
God help me.
We're not even going to describe it. We're just going to have to sit your asses down and watch it. For those of you who were fortunate enough to catch last week's The Last Drive-In, the second feature, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Don't breathe a word to it, though. I want their surprise. I want their reactions to be legitimate.
God help me.
Oh, you can pray to your God, but spoiler warning, I won't be listening.
Anyway,
story.
Let's this weekend went for you guys.
Let's get to the meat of this. First up, when we got there, a huge shout out to Scott Zillner, who runs the show, who runs Morphicon. Guy could not be nicer helping us. We had a little trouble getting the banner up at first, but he came along like a champ and gave us some pro advice. And thankfully, we didn't have to drag tables and chairs. They were actually provided for us. Gotta give them that. That was way better than hauling them around for 4 hours, right, Mike?
Definitely.
Yeah. Yep. So it was pretty much, we just had to bring in our stuff, set up the banner, and it was good to go. I mean, it wasn't a chore. So yeah, that was pretty sweet.
We thought we were going to be there for at least an hour, about 30 minutes to an hour to do all this. And no, they were great and had everything set up. Even showed us exactly where we're going to be.
Yeah. We were lucky enough because we got a seat right across from the Boom Studios booth.
Oh, nice. Ooh.
Yeah, right across from there. Kyle Higgins was there, a couple other guys, but we went there a lot. Yeah. Speaking of which, Mike, I guess I should tell you now while we're on the air, you left your Ranger Slayer pin here. I'll mail it to you.
Okay.
That's what buddies do. But yeah, we scored some sweet stuff there. I had to get the Shattered Grid bolt from the Shattered Grid, obviously. I got that pin, a May the Power Protect You pin. Mike originally said to surprise him because I decided to spring one for him because I'm nice like that. I got him a Solar Ranger pin.
Oh, nice.
Well, well, you're surprised, aren't you? Yes. But he went back and traded it.
Yeah, like I said, Ranger Slayer is a more awesome character, I think.
Hey, you said it surprised you, so I picked the most random thing I could find.
Absolutely. Like I said, I am the king of random around here.
Yep. Also picked up first few volumes so I can finally finish Shattered Grid, hopefully. Sadly, they haven't come out with the trade paperback for the full event yet, but this is a good start. Yep. Speaking of Shattered Grid, I might as well get the big one out of the way. So I went to a certain booth early. There's only one guy in front of me. We had to wait a while, but eventually, after a little waiting, a little patience makes all the difference at a convention, the lovely Erin Cahill made her way to the booth. And I just got to say, after she chatted with the first guy, hey, Maddie.
No.
Maddie!
What?
She remembers me!
Sweet.
Nice.
Oh, that's awesome.
Had a little trouble remembering my name, but she recognized me from the interview. And I was just like, Erin, honey, you got to get out to Florida again sometime. She says she's thinking about it. So,
good.
Knock on wood, Erin will be back at Ranger Stop. We don't know yet. We have not confirmed anything. So, yeah, I just asked her. She's thinking about it.
Hey, that's good enough.
So, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Hey, fingers crossed, guys. That's
for government work.
Fingers crossed. I said, Erin, you come down there, drinks are on me.
She said
take me up on that.
Easy, you weren't the only one she remembered.
Aha, yes. Let Mike talk. He's got stories for days.
She remembered. She remembered me as well from her when she was down at Ranger Stop. Again, same thing. Didn't quite remember the name, but did recognize me.
How do you forget that Fez?
It's working the gimmick.
Exactly.
Yeah, right. Now, I actually remember there's something else important about your location that made a big difference, because you weren't just across from the Boom Studios booth, you were next to somebody else.
Yes, our backdoor neighbor.
Yeah. We lucked out, because as soon as we got there the first day and started setting up, guess who popped through the curtain at our booth? A certain black/green ranger who never got his simple explanation. That's right. Azeem Rizk's booth was right behind us. He actually popped out and said, just wondering who my neighbor is. That guy was a trip. Oh, my God. He actually popped in a lot to check on us or to sneak out. And Scott used it a lot too. He's like, I'm basically using you guys as a shortcut right now. It's like, that's okay. I'm used to it.
And then again, so did we.
Yep.
Well, only turnabout's fair play. I mean, he's using us for a shortcut. We'll use him for a shortcut.
There you go.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yep. I do have some good news, bad news though about that. I did get a certain video with Azeem. Yes. That's good. But I should have waited for the second day because he was in his Megaforce costume. That's bad. Hey, I'm happy with what I got. I'm just like, stupid.
You know what, Easy? At least you got it. I mean, how more difficult would it have been to have gotten it in costume?
That's fair. But, you know, just I would have preferred the choice. But, you know.
Anyway.
That's true.
The story of how we got that to video, though.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
okay.
Yes.
You tell it, Mike.
Oh, yes, because I was the one that was geniusing on this one. So we're sitting at the Easy's booth, watching the people go by. Azeem's behind us. I take a quick look behind, seeing that, his line's not too terribly busy. And I come up with the idea. So we have Sierra's clip already. I'm thinking this. How competitive are these rangers against each other?
No.
So I come up with the idea. I'm thinking Sierra pulled this line off perfectly. Easy's take, Azeem can do it better. So once we see his lines empty, we pop through from the other side. like you do, and we show him the clip. And I flat out say, I think Sierra pulled this line off awesomely. Easy, of course, Easy's come back is saying that no, he can do it better. Right then and there, it seems right up for it. Get the phone out. Get the video. We're doing this right now.
Nice.
Yeah, a lot of what we shot was on Mike's phone, believe it or not. I did not drag my camcorder out that much. I didn't think I needed it, but lo and behold. Yeah, because this was a self-promotion convention, not a work my ass off for a few interviews convention.
Yeah, I understand.
But we got a certain video. You'll probably see that in the next review, whenever that is. So that was awesome.
Nice.
Yeah, but it didn't stop there. I should let Mike tell all the stories of visiting all the guests because he's got those for days. Plus, I got to check out something. BRB. Four is yours, Mike.
Certainly. And then, of course, Yuta and Rika was there. And, one time when Easy was wandering the floor, Yuta actually comes by and seen a bit of Easy's review of Shinkenger versus RPM. So the RPM Shinkenger.
Shinkenger versus Gowanger.
Yes, basically that review. Yuta comes up and says, O-Ranger? And no, I do correct him saying no, Shinkenger, and he agrees with that and just walks on. But So Yuta came by, and then of course I'm in my full Doctor Who get up, walking around walking through the guest alley, and Easy said there was not a Linageddon. That's not entirely true. There was one section that was Linageddon, but of course you know who that was for.
Austin.
No.
Well, that's no surprise. Let's be honest with ourselves here.
But like I said, I'm walking through with my Doctor Who regalia and my Beast driver. Of course, it's Texas. You have to have a big belt buckle. And I do.
Of course.
So, but Mike Olasky recognizes the Doctor. Get up.
Nice.
And, of course, gets quite a few Fez's are cool comments as well. And then I come up to Paul Schreier. And I believe Paul also remembered me from Ranger Stop.
Nice, nice.
And then, of course, I show off the Beast driver, and he suddenly gets out of his phone and says, "Let me film you doing that again."
Nice.
He says he also filmed it in slow motion.
Yes.
Wow.
Note to self: after the stream, go check out Paul's Facebook page.
I've been following it as well myself. But so pretty much.
That's a thing.
And I'm back, and I heard everything. Mike, actually, what you were thinking of was the Clash of the Red Rangers review.
Yeah,
you were close. You were close. I haven't reviewed the Sentai version yet.
But that's the review he was watching and saw and thought made the comment, O-Ranger. No, and like I said, he probably didn't know that was Samurai, so Power Ranger Samurai, so I just said Shinkenger, and
Well, you doesn't have to be an
Close
expert.
Enough.
He doesn't have to be an expert.
No, no one's expecting that, but hey, at least he had some fun, but at least you got to say hi to Yuta Mochizuka. I wouldn't be complaining.
Yes.
I actually talked to Reiko Chiba a little bit while I was waiting in line for Aaron. We, said good morning to each other. My Japanese was terrible, but I still got to say Ohio. She got it. She nodded and got the. She got
nice.
It. Probably screwed it up, but I'm saying, hey, I'm cool with that. I got to talk to her, and I got as Mike said, you walked around, so we got that out of the way. I wanted to talk to Paul the second day, but it was later in the day. There was a terrible thunderstorm that day. It kind of distracted us. Especially when we were trying to grab some grub for lunch. But by the time we did that, I thought, you know what? I should go to Paul's booth and ask about Greg Bullock, a.k.a. Lieutenant Stone, see if there's been any update. So I circle back around. Paul's gone.
Damn.
Dang it. Oh, well.
And my one other story is that Catherine Sutherland still thinks I'm dressing up as Grunkle Stan from Gravity Falls.
We're keeping that joke going.
Ah, son of a bitch.
May as well.
Though I still kind of have to brag. I think I got the better Yutamochi Zuki story with what happened at Ranger Stop this last year.
Yeah, no one's topping that story.
For those who have not heard this,
not even my Dr. Fu.
No. For those who didn't hear about this at Ranger Stop last year, we were out in the back area by the pool. And these guys were talking with some of the guys of the Florida Toku Club. And, of course, I've been vaping, so I walk over to the smoking area to go take a few hits. And both Yuta and Reiko are sitting there. Because, you know, apparently Yuta smokes. So I'm sitting there just puffing away. And I quickly say hi to Yuta. Just, you know, to say hi to both of them. Just like, how you guys doing? How's you enjoying the weekend? And then remember at this time, if you were watching my videos around this time, you remember I had my beard fully grown out and I had it tied up to try to get look, which did not work, which is why I've since shaved it off. But I had that going on, and Yuta walks over to me, and I'm like, what, is there something on my face? And like, that's the first thought in my mind. I'm like, what's going on? And he just starts messing with my little beard thing, and he just starts laughing at it. He's like, it looks funny. Like, I was like, well, okay, I just got my beard touched by Yuta Mochizuka. My weekend is now May. I immediately, after I was done, I walked over and I told the boys, I'm like, guys, my weekend's done. I can't top that.
Yeah, I don't think there's any topping that.
No.
Again, like I said, there's no way we're topping that.
Anyway, back to you guys. So let's keep the focus on you guys.
Like Mike said, JDS line was long as hell. And what I thought was funny is, like, of course the guys have more security than the president, but I was like, I thought this was classy of him. He always came in a suit. He didn't come all casually like everyone else.
He looked like he was taking care of business.
He was.
He looked spiffy.
Yeah, looking very dapper.
Yeah.
Yeah. Of course, I wasn't going to stand in that line to meet him, but you get what I mean.
There are pictures. There are pictures from the weekend.
Yep. And I also talked to Brad Hawkins, and I remember that cameo I said I got from him.
Yeah.
Which I haven't been able to use yet. I actually apologized to Brad and say I'm going to use it. As soon as I get my 100th episode done, I'm going to focus on a VR Troopers review. I'm going to use that. He remembered me, actually, from Morphicon. He said, it's okay. Take your time. I was like, whew, that's a load off my mind.
Yeah.
I felt bad. I haven't used it yet, but it's just other requests and reviews have come up. It's just kind of put it on the back burner. But I will do that, and I do have a cameo from Brad, so look forward to that sometime in the future. But that was a load off my mind. Yep. But we also took in the this was a big surprise for me. One of the local indie toku guys, guy who runs the Immortal Red Fox, Mike?
Yeah, the Immortal Red Fox.
Yeah, he comes over and says he's a huge fan of my work. I'm like, what, really? I'm just like, he's like, he says I'm an inspiration to guys doing local toku. I'm just like blown away. Wow. Gave me a free poster, which looks sweet, by the way. It's hanging in my studio right now. Mike got one, too. And it's just like, wow. I was like, you know what, guys? I want to do a spotlight episode on you guys. He said, that'd be great. So I'm like, yeah, I'm all about helping local toku. To paraphrase my bro, Matty J over here, I'm Easy Rider reminding you to help indie tokusatsu support or help tokusatsu or help fan projects support your independent tokusatsu as soon as possible.
Yeah, that'll work.
I'll take it.
That's a one shot deal, Maddie. I won't be using that, but you get what I mean.
Hey, you know what? Imitation is the sincerest form of flattery. I'm okay with that.
Indeed.
Yeah. So that was a surprise for me. I Deca Mexican passed by a few times, said hi. Didn't really get a chance to chat with him. Kevin, the director, was there, obviously. Said hi to him. Sweet guy. We still owe him big time for helping us.
Yeah.
So big shout out to Kevin. My favorite cosplay, hands down. The Golden yes. Cosplay Award goes to the guy who went around dressed as Ernie from Mighty Morphin. He had a nice. Tray of drinks and everything.
Nice.
That guy was a trip. And he actually came over, and I don't remember if he knew who I was or not, but it was great talking to him. I mean, that's dedication right there.
That must have been one of the times I was out walking around as well.
Yeah. Mm.
I was behind one of your favorite photos of the con, though.
Oh.
The Roxy cosplay.
Oh yeah.
She saw it.
It's once again, it's time for bragging with the rider. So,
yes.
So I see this Roxy cosplayer walking around, and I'm a little too nervous to ask her because anxiety and everything. I know it sucks. So Mike does me a huge solid and gets her to come over here. And I've got my Go Busters gear on. I got my transpod. I got my Go Busters weapons and my Morphin brace. We take a picture. It's on my Twitter. And she actually wanted to take a comparison photo because she's got the Beast X Morpher. And we do a side-by-side. And again, I'm just like, I'm blown away at how good the Beast X Morpher is. Luckily, I find it that day, but we'll get to that. And so that went up on her Twitter. I forget what her handle is, but I'll link it to you guys if I can dig through it later. But anyway, afterwards, posted that later, and I said, I ran into Roxy at Power Morphicon Express. I don't know whether to open fire or fall in love. And, of course, I tagged Roxy herself in it. I tagged Leanna Ramirez in it. And she retweeted it and marked the hell out.
Yes!
So that made my day. And holy shit, that picture is still getting some love. I've lost count of how many likes and retweets that's gotten.
But the whole reason behind all that, sure, I actually bumped into her waiting in line for Aaron. She bumps into me and instant it was a Doctor Who fan as well.
Ah!
Yes. So that's when I said, okay, after I got through with Aaron, came back, told Easy to just take a walk through the guest row. Don't have to worry about interacting with her or anything. Just take a look at her. And then that's when you mark out for being an awesome cosplay that she had.
Yep.
And that's when I decided to go out and make the move to get the picture.
Yeah. Again, Mike, I couldn't have done that without you, buddy.
This man has earned his keep for the year.
Yeah.
Yep.
For the millennium.
Yep.
This is why we keep this motherfucker around, folks. This guy gets shit done.
That's why Mike is my handler. That's why if you want to go through me or want to talk to me, you got to go through him first.
Not like that's hard to do, but still.
Yeah. See, Mike, you're more than just my meal ticket. But yeah, I didn't invite Mike just because he was nearby. He does a ton of shit for me. I mean, he's what to me as what CJ is to the champ.
Hey, there you go.
Yeah. Hi, champ, if you're listening. So yeah, I'm trying to think what else happened. Spoils of War. Spoils of War. Mike didn't do much shopping, really. But we can tell you what we saw. This one guy... Maddie, you're going to hate me for this. There was one guy who had a perfect Astromorpher from In Space. Light, sounds, work. It wasn't all rusted out like mine.
Or mine.
Guy wanted $175 for it.
Ugh, Jesus!
I was like, Christ. Yeah, I talked about that with Mike, and he said, hell no! He talked me out
of
it.
I would not. I wouldn't. $175.
I know, right? Suck. That's highway robbery. Hmm. So, yeah, I'm glad Mike talked me out of that.
Yeah, Mike, good job.
Yeah. It didn't help that my... Oh, shit. I didn't bring this up, but... guess whose dad showed up at the convention?
No.
Mine did. So yeah, my dad and my sister were there to see basically how I do things. They didn't stay long, maybe a few hours, but they saw me talking to fans, signing stuff, you know, it's like that. And I think dad finally got it through his thick skull that this is actually something important. Because, you know, parents, you know, you tell them you're doing something on the internet, they roll their eyes, they don't believe it. But I think after they decided to leave, he said he was proud of me, so worth it.
Hey, that's a win.
Yep.
Yeah.
So that was gratifying. That was gratifying.
I bet Mike was
there. He can confirm.
Oh, indeed.
Yeah. Yeah. So that was worth it. So, yeah. They wanted to see how I do things. So yeah, that was. Thankfully, they didn't embarrass me. Dad has a habit of being a motor mouth, running his mouth. Thankfully, he kept his mouth shut.
Yeah, my dad's kind of the same way. That's part of the reason why I don't talk with him anymore. But that's a whole other can of worms.
Exactly. So yeah. Things I did get, thankfully I waited the last day for this, but one guy did have some Time Ranger stuff. He actually had both the regular Time Ranger badge with the little mutant container dealy. And then I see behind that, the Time Fire one. I'm like, I gotta freaking have this. They're both 100, but he's like, you know, he tried to sell both of them for 200. I'm like, eh. He says, okay, I'll give you one for 90. I'm like, sold, American. So yeah, I finally got some more Time Ranger swag. Time Ranger, everyone hates you but me. So that was a thing. Also, give me a second. Mike, distract them.
Let's see here. What else did I, let's see here. So, yeah, just basically lots of Doctor Who love. Even got a shout out from the handler for Steve Cardenas recognizing the Doctor Who.
Oh, nice!
Nice.
Oh yeah, she was a hot little thing.
I'm back and yep. There's a shocker. You don't have to do the bill, Maddie. You don't have to do the bill, Maddie, or not today, not anymore if you don't want to, because. I was digging through all the collectible gimmicks and whatnot at one table. Wizard rings, Gaia memories, Gashats. No, they didn't have Poppy, sadly. Sorry, JoJo. Aww. Well, then again, I would have had to decide if I want to keep it or give it to her. So, yeah, I'm digging through all this stuff, and I dig this thing out. I'm like, I see there's a shocker face on it. There's a shocker face on it, and I shake it. I'm like, what's in there? Are those mints? So it was only $20. So I thought, okay, why not? And so I get it over there to Mike. We open it up, and inside there's candy. And in fact, we have a video for that.
Damn.
Ooh. We have a video for that. I'll post that later. But we do have a let's try. Not bad.
Okay.
Not bad. So I thought, you know what? You know what? Shocker, you might be made of Nazis, but you make some good candy.
All right. Okay.
So yeah, I decided, you know what? After that, this was going to be my new mint box. Got my Tic Tacs in there. I'm like, you know what? I'm going to carry this to future conventions. And now every time we bring up, there's a shocker, I can just shake this.
Well, that's awesome.
Yeah. So yeah, that's about all I really got at Morphicon Express, plus the aforementioned pins and comics. Yep. I wouldn't say there wasn't much to get there. It's just a lot of the stuff they had was overpriced as hell. But that's a convention for you.
Yeah.
I mean, they had Power Rangers figure arts, $100 a pop.
Damn.
Right?
Jesus. I didn't pay that much at Morphicon last year.
I know, right?
That's
and they had a blue, they had a Blue Ranger. They had a Blue Ranger.
Okay.
I'm just like, dang, I could have gotten this for Maddie if it weren't so damn expensive.
Yeah.
I do already have a Blue Ranger though.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
I think I got it last year, as a matter of fact.
Okay. Well, they also had the Power Rangers figures too. That also comes with the Lance.
Ah,
we've gotten that too, but oh well. That's the price I pay for trying to be nice.
Yeah. All right. So with that said, are we ready to move on to the episode?
One other little announcement. Must make this point. Because we got a Ranger birthday today.
Honey?
Ooh.
Monica May.
Oh, you're right.
Good old Miss May.
Yes.
She is a delight.
She is. Mm. She's such a treat.
In more ways than one, but we'll not bring that up.
Yep.
But yeah, we got other business to do, don't we?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, we got to brag about how I got this Beast X Morpher. Okay, one more story before we go, before we get to the episode. So I've checked out, we went to a Target or two Saturday, because everyone at the convention said, try Target. We went there. Also, we had to go to an Office Depot because I literally ran out of title cards. I mean business cards. I mean, all my business cards are gone. All of them. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but they're all gone. So we tried to print up some more. That fell through. They couldn't print it because it was too bright or something. I don't know. Doesn't matter. I just ordered 500 more with updated links, Mike. So don't worry. So we're heading back to my place after a good day at the convention. And I thought, you know what? I haven't tried my local Target yet. I know, right? I haven't had time. So we thought, why not? We'll go in there, see if they've got Beast Morphers toys. Lo and behold, they have a few Beast X Morphers left. And I'm just like, oh, I wish I had brought my camera in here. Mike is genius in again.
I have my camera. Phone.
Yeah, his phone. He whips out his phone. And we recorded that little bit that's on the Recap Facebook page and on my Twitter if you've not seen it. So... Ooh, I think we've earned this after today, and apologies in advance. Yoshalucky!
Yoshalucky.
Oh, you earned it. You earned it.
You've earned it. No complaints from me.
Yep, so, yeah. Yep. Hey, don't knock it, Kira. Vistaprint does some damn good title cards.
Pretty sure that's who I use to get my business cards.
Yeah, same here, as a matter of fact. I will not... Yeah, Vistaprint... We hope, we wish we could be sponsored by them.
Yeah, I know. They also did my convention banner.
Nice.
Yep. So that was cool. So yeah, after that it was a good day. We went home, saw what was left of Mania. I'm sure Maddie will have a bunch to say about that tomorrow.
Hashtag save it for the WrestleCast.
Yep.
Oh my God! You know what? Easy. I shared the meme earlier, but I feel like Homer Simpson after that pile of cheese. Marge coming in. Did you watch all that wrestling? I think I'm blind.
Although, I will say this though. Easy did have a few markout moments.
Oh, yes.
I think I know of which ones you speak of.
Yep. Also, got Mike here hooked on Doom Patrol. We binged that whole almost all the episodes. I think I got Mike hooked now.
Indeed.
Yeah, that for those who don't know, that's where we got our new Deus Ex button.
And since I haven't really had a chance to play it much, I'll go ahead and play that for you guys here.
Aha! Your Deus Ex is right on time.
Ooh, actually. I know it's irrelevant to what I'm talking about. Would you play one of those new buns I sent you yesterday? Just so
before,
easy. Knows
before you do have. That, before you do that, the guy who said that awesome awesome line is the one and only Alan Tudyk, and me and Mike both agreed he should be the next master for Doctor Who. Am I right, Mike?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, he would kill it. He would kill it. If you have not seen Doom Patrol, but go ahead, Mike. Go ahead, Maddie.
All right. Anyway, actually, he wanted me to hit one of the buttons here, so I'm going to hit this one.
It's funny. Never mind.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Hall of Fame. I think
I believe, Easy, you know what I'm talking about, but.
Yes, I do. Yeah.
Yep. Anyway.
WrestleCast. No can do, cure. No can do for the WrestleCast because Friday nights belong to my Friday nights belong to one man, Joe Bob Briggs.
There you go.
I never miss an episode.
You tear him away from his Joe Bob Briggs time.
Not even Mike could do that. Not even Mike could do that.
Because I ain't even gonna try.
You want to try that? Go ahead. Let me know how that goes.
He had me at gunpoint to try to get back from getting dinner to get back to his place for Joe Bob.
Yes. Yes. Thank God we got it to go. But yeah. Anyway, I guess that's all for tonight. Episode.
Yeah, I was about to say.
Oh, you're gonna complain about that.
Yeah. Yeah, we got an episode to get to, so let's get to that.
Don't mind me, just coming up with another awesome tweet for Roxy herself to like and retweet.
Also,
what can I say, boys? I'm smitten.
Also, if I've got my band names correctly, let's kind of put a cap on the BTO jokes.
Damn it!
BTO is such a great band.
No, that's my one joke limit. That's the
one joke limit. Done and dusted. Double damn it!
Because I already know you fuckers in the chat were thinking it.
All I'm going to say is to stay tuned to the Stinger.
Dino with the last drive-in because drive-ins are all but extinct, my friend. That's the joke. But yeah, actually, Matt, if you bothered to watch the episode, you should have made a car wash joke.
Oh, no, don't worry about me, man. I got my few jokes in my head.
Fair enough.
Yeah, I'm the one that's going in blind because I haven't had a chance.
You're not the only one.
Yeah, actually, we forgot to get up and watch the episode before the convention. My bad.
It happens. Dragon Zeron, BTO, Bachman Turner Overdrive. They're the band that sings the song Taking Care of Business. Hence why I said, beware that be limited on the jokes for it, because most people will probably already have that song in their head as we speak.
Too late for me anyway.
Nah. Anyway. Let us get this going. Hopefully you have your episode up from whatever resources available to you, preferably a legal one, but we know you're limited. Mike, you also have the episode loaded up?
I've got the last episode as well.
All right. Hopefully yours has the intro because some of them don't. But that being said, let's get this started. Power Rangers Beast Morphers, episode 5, Taking Care of Business. In 3, 2, 1, play.
You go to the car wash.
Taking Care of Business. That's my favorite 80s comedy. Oh, wait. No, it isn't.
Sudsy? Real? Your name is Sudsy?
Wow. I'm going to name my kid Sudsy. Then he'll have to go into the car wash business. saving the world. Don't forget you heard that.
Oh, you! Oh no!
Did he say Backstreet Brawler? 3, I guess you could say Backstreet's back. All right.
God damn it!
If I didn't make the joke, Mike would. Meanwhile, in the.
You sound like a drug addict needing his next hit, Evox.
Yep. Also, seriously, could you keep the evil speeches down? The tall man's going to come over and complain again.
You know, Evox, as a wrestling fan, you're tempting me to make a Jake the Snake Roberts joke, and I don't want to do that. All right, Damien, calm down. Damn it!
He needs to work on his Jeremy Irons impression.
He does.
Will Sasso!
Holy crap, he's lost weight.
Actually, it looks like Lovelica from X-Aid.
He does.
He's bulked up.
Oh, no, it's their dad!
Of course. Well, I think we know how they got the job.
Oh, what fresh hell?
No. Oh, what fresh hell is this?
They reprogrammed one of the bots.
Those poor suit actors are going to be like, okay, what am I doing today? You're going to be a dog. Okay. I was going to say, what did one of the crash test dummies ever do to you? I have no children. Actually, doesn't he look like the commander from Atlantic Rim? I keep expecting him to say bull butter any second.
So they're actually going to, you know, that's what they always wondered. Why don't you just take some of the goons and study them? You can learn something from that. They're doing it again!
They're listening.
Also, I can't concentrate on the good shit when I look at a Red Ranger and going, it's me, Mario!
You beat me to it.
Damn it! Why didn't I think of that?
It's the overalls. It's the overalls. Yeah, I can't help it.
You're right. Whoa. That car got in a fight with a mud hole, and the mud hole won.
Give the bunny a hand.
Bunnycopter! Working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living.
See, that's what sucks. All he's got to do is say, "Hey, just give me a job at Grid Battle Force. I'll work there."
Seriously, I'm pretty sure Grid Battle Force compensates its Rangers. At least I hope so. At least I hope they get medical and benefits. Also, too bad we don't have a big red Zord to carry all these parts. Oh wait. Wow, usually a mayor would only do this for a puff piece.
Wait, bonding time with father and son? They're not at each other's throats?
Oh,
what madness is this?
God.
Wow, it's refreshing to see a ranger and dad not either fighting each other or dad already dead. Or missing.
This week on this old storage container.
When you're about to turn a circular construction saw into a giga drone, you're shaking hands with danger.
You legit just gave me a mark out moment, dude. I did not think of that.
Well, some things never change. The bad names for robots, yeah, that never goes away.
And the puns. And the
and
puns.
As soon as Blaze heard that voice from that monster, he's like, ugh, forget it. Ha! I wonder what that could be!
Talk about foreshadowing.
Subtle series.
Yeah, subtle's a sledgehammer.
Subtle. Jeez, why don't you just shove it down our throats?
Of course.
Couldn't he just tell them it's an elaborate Apple Watch or a Fitbit?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's one for Blaze. Ouch.
And the Blades from Wild Wild West, didn't we should do a joke like this last week?
I'm pretty sure we did.
Yep. Also, we're on the intro right now if you folks need to skip ahead or pause.
Can I just mention, if I see a giant spider in this at this show, God damn it, Kevin, that producer that produced Wild Wild West is involved in this. Calling it now.
Especially if it's a giant robot spider.
I'm pretty sure those blades cut their car to shreds.
Yep.
Also, extreme dodgeball.
Also, how come we're not hiring this guy to slice up?
No clue.
Hey, also, is anybody getting flashbacks to Twisted Metal 4 playing as Pizza Boy?
Yeah.
Wait, is this a construction site or a freighter? Shouldn't have had that falafel for lunch. Again, construction site or a freighter? I can't tell.
God damn it, no!
Make it
You know what? It's the villain. He's got to be a heel. Fine, but stop it with the puns.
Leave the one-liners to the heroes. The villains are supposed to be loquacious and foreboding. Ah, we're under some plaster. Help! Damn it, Barry! I'll wait. Wrong red speedster. Oh! Again, that's one for Blaze. Ouch.
Oh, he makes up for it, that's for sure. He's kicking your ass.
Man, having to put a key in everything must suck. I like how they're keeping Robbie's overheating in continuity.
Yeah.
Next time, bring a compress, though. Now you tell us. When did car washes become so busy again? What happened to those self-service ones?
I know, right?
Thanks, Discount Red Green. If you start clapping, Robbie, I swear to God. For a cut of your paycheck, of course. Yeah, again. Wow, look at them trying to cover up the label on that truck.
Not to mention, did you see the paint on that thing? That thing doesn't need a car wash. It needs a paint job.
Chevy, like a rock. Oh, like a rock! Oh, my God, Roxy, I love you. Roxy,
ladies and gentlemen.
Roxy, what are you doing?
She's geniusing.
She's geniusing.
Ladies and gentlemen, Roxy, the world's smartest villain.
God, I love this one. Wrong.
And took the cell phones, too. And just outright destroyed them. Didn't even give them a chance.
And you gotta love how none of the Rangers have depth perception. Or can you hear a giant saw whirring?
That is genius.
Pretty sure we would have heard that from here. Uh-oh. Yeah, I hate to call Sudsy's work ethic here, but shouldn't employees have lockers?
Yeah.
My dead-end job has lockers. But I have access to it. Got a world to save. Yeah, tell my father to lick me. I'm trying to save the world. Go ahead. Go ahead. Sorry.
And Chewbacca says the Padres is going to come into the episode. I'm disappointed. And then 2 minutes later, there's going to be like a fucking thing where he says he's proud of the Power Rangers or something. You fucking watch.
I'll take a piece of that action.
Yeah.
Now, don't get me wrong. If they prove me right, then fair enough. But at the same time, it's working the gimmick.
Yep. Oh, speak of the devil. Mm-hmm. Well, not everyone's meant to work at a car wash. Haven't you ever seen Richard Pryor in car wash?
Ooh, good call.
He wasn't working there. He was a pimp.
Oh, shit.
Uh-oh!
Oh, fuck.
Attack of the killer hubcaps. Deja vu. Hey. Oh, thank God, the Flash is here. Oh, it's the Red Ranger. Never mind.
And they broke glass. Oh, crap. That monster's gonna get an ass whooping now.
Boy, I wish my son was as cool as the Red Ranger.
Yeah, funny thing about that.
You're my real son, Ranger. I have no son. He ain't no helicopter, Papa. Sink or swim, bitch. Talk to the head, because the face ain't listening. Yep, here's your new Giga Drone, ready for the saw upgrade. Got that thing order ready to go out here. There.
If you Giga ain't drone. Cheating, you ain't trying.
Yep. Giga Drone delivery. Delivery in 10 seconds or it's free. You mean one with a saw attachment? Yeah, that is rare.
The saw is part of me. And listen, Madness, because I'm going to make it part of you.
Maybe that Giga Drone needs a bone saw. He's ready.
Hey. Hey, Giga Drone, yeah. You're going nowhere, yeah. Nowhere at all. Yeah, I got you for 3 minutes, yeah. 3 minutes of playtime, yeah. Where's your Slim Jim, yeah.
You're having way too much fun with that, Maddie.
Blow me.
Working his gimmick.
Yep.
Oh, another talk to the hand.
Tucker's got an AT field. What is this, Evangelion?
Careful, building bump. Do not break the building.
Also, he's got protect and reflect casted, like any cheap Final Fantasy villain.
Dipshit.
I hate those guys. Have you tried turning me off and on? Yeah, I don't think that's going to work. This tower has a refreshing mint flavor.
Eat at Joe's. Eat at Joe's. Eat at Joe's.
Suck. Suck. Suck.
Suck.
Suck.
Suck.
Suck.
The Sleep and Fuck Motel. Sleep, fuck. Sleep, fuck. Big neon sign.
Wait. If they could pilot their Zord sentient, why aren't they always on, you know, why aren't they always on call? Why aren't they always in their Zords ready to deploy in case something like this happens? You'd think.
I get the feeling that whenever they do the Megazord thing, they need the pilots in there.
Yeah.
I think it's a tag team affair for our bill.
Oh, no, I don't think in GoBusters. I don't think in GoBusters they could fly solo. The mechas couldn't move by themselves. Yeah, original Zord footage. Yeah. This ooh, nice. Plate spinning. Nice.
Oh.
Na 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 na. Wow. Wow.
Time to send the slicer back to where it's going to be needed. To your local Arby's.
Oh.
I'm so hungry I could eat it. We have the meat.
Explosions. For sandwiches.
Explosions.
Oh, okay, fair enough.
Yeah, but Sentai footage. We kind of got to explode this thing.
Oh!
He hit the power button! Oh!
Lever!
Oh, this is geniusin'.
That is clever. You know, that thing powering down and being bricked like that, that would make perfect sense if it was an Xbox.
Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, no. God. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. All right, we're gonna catch her. Oh,
I kind of caught her.
Good. Yeah. Benny boy, you got a future in pro graps, my friend.
Ooh.
That's part one. And there's two. Easy. This must be how it feels to be right.
Ooh.
Woo. Easy, this must be how it feels to be right about something.
Yeah, yeah. Pick up the phone, because this son of a bitch over here just...
called it.
I mean, it's classic booking here, but... the feels.
Hey, I like how this episode shows you how it really is working in the real life, Keys. Hey, you can't spend all your life in mommy and daddy's basement. Some of us have to go out there and get a job that we hate.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Them's the breaks.
Still, once again, the amazing writing of this series just shining through. All of the continuity, all of the moments, all of those, why don't they just do this? Oh, wait, they actually did this time.
Yeah. And the villains, the villains geniusing by destroying their communicators.
Mm.
Good thing they had some backups, am I right?
Yeah.
Hey, Adak, I think that goes without saying, but at the same time, it's like, part of me is like, well, all they have to do is say, hey, we're going to hire your, we found your kid. We think he's got some potential. We'll hire him for Grand Battle Force as a cover for him working, ironically enough, for Grand Battle Force.
Yeah.
Seriously, this whole thing could be solved with the commander just pulling the mayor aside, said, look, your son is accidentally a ranger. He has to work for us now. So again, this all could be solved with a chat.
See, I'm going to counter that because here's the thing.
I think you're about to counter the point I was about to make. Go ahead.
Cause here's the thing. Yeah. She could reveal to the mayor, but why wouldn't the mayor use that to bolster his own, you know, popular opinion? He's a politician. They're going to do that shit. So she has to be careful he doesn't find out. However, I do like Maddie's idea of saying, hey, you know, this, you know, Devin came to us and we took a look at what he can do and he's got some potential in a particular department of ours, so we're going to hire him on board.
Hell, say he's working in the laundry room like Zoe was. Boom, problem solved.
And the other point of why they established in the first episode, well, we prefer not to reveal our identities for everyone's safety. Continuity is upheld. Kayfabe is upheld.
Yeah. Again, they are keeping they're keeping this tied to the books. And again, like we mentioned the scene earlier, like after that first fight, you have Devin using that cooling fan to keep himself from overheating. And just long after, Zoe's chewing on a carrot again to keep her energy up. They're not just having that come up when it's plot convenient. It's that little moment where they didn't need to do that. They could have just not done that. But the fact that they did, that attention to detail really shows how much they kept this series going. It's those little things that you don't think about. And yeah, a lot of original footage, even original Zord footage. When's the last time we had a series do that? Just so much.
I got a feeling they're going somewhere with this, capturing that whole Giga drone. You know what? I'm willing to bet that's the catalyst for putting all three Zords together.
I was thinking the exact same thing. It's like, and that's another shocker. We are 5 episodes in, and we still haven't seen the Megazord. Wow! No season has done that before.
You see that, kiddies? That's what we call pacing.
Yes, and it's so refreshing. It's so different. We've never seen that. Not even Mighty Morphin pulled that shit off. No season in history has gone more than 5 episodes without a Megazord.
Which I'm glad they're doing. Also, I think another reason I say that is because, keep in mind, Devin had trouble putting this one down. I think it's like the next one's going to be too tough for him to take on. It's like, okay, we got to do this as a team.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you could tell in the civilian life, he was doing the work, but he's like, at the same time, like, God damn, I got to disappoint my dad to save the world.
Yeah.
There's that internal struggle right there.
That's character. He could have easily just said, oh, my ranger duty's coming first, but he wanted to keep going in the job because he didn't want to disappoint his dad. No, and then realizing later he still had to. And they showed the consequences. He gets fired, his dad chews him out. That whole thing, that is character. Oh.
At least Hasbro, your dad's around.
Hasbro has done in 5 episodes what Saban couldn't do in, let's see, let's not count the super seasons. Let's say Samurai is 4 seasons.
8 years.
So 4 series, if you want to be able.
Yeah, 8 fucking years. These guys did in 6 weeks, skipping that 1 week.
Give or take.
In 6 weeks, this show has done what Neil Saban couldn't do in 8 fucking years. How the hell?
And you could argue that in Dino Charge, they came close, and I would say fair enough, but like 3 Rangers, 5 episodes, you are more invested in this that we were, I argue, with Dino Charge.
Yeah.
And we were invested in Dino Charge.
We were. But compared to this, we might as well have not even pretend. We could pretend that didn't even exist. And that's the good one. That's not even talking about the other 3 seasons where, oh, good God. It was just one disappointment after another. And this season has already beaten it by miles within 5 episodes. That is unreal. How scary.
Also, villains that we actually like and are invested in and are actually competent. Again, something we haven't had since Dino Charge. I mean, Roxy and Blaze are right up there with Heckle for me as good villains.
I'll come out and say it. They topped Heckle.
I know.
Cause yeah, that scene where Roxy's like, hey, their communicators are unguarded. They didn't fuck around. Blaze went right in there, stole not only their communicators / their morphers, but their cell phones, and without even giving the Rangers a chance to see it, sliced them in half.
Gotta go, Ken Titus on this one, Maddie. Now. Bet you're not going to do that again, are you?
Yeah.
Pretty much.
So, yeah, bottom line, final rating for me, no question, thumbs up.
Yes. 5 out of motherfucking 5.
Thumbs up.
That's a thumbs up.
I think to steal a bit from the from Sunday, S rank.
Damn.
Yep.
And as Voice points out in the chat, all of this from a Sentai where less is more. No collectible gimmicks, no multiple weapons or forms, just the bare basics. And they're pulling off this much.
Yeah, that's just wow.
Chip, Becca, Alwyn, all you guys, we're sorry we ever gave you shit during Neo Saban.
You're forgiven.
You are beyond forgiven. We apologize. You did not deserve the shit talking we gave you over the last 8 years. It is clear to us, well, 4 years for them, but still. We shit talked them a lot because we honestly thought it was their fault that the Power Rangers gotten that bad. We have been proven wrong. We are eating crow right now, and we are loving it. God damn. But I believe it is time for us to pass things over to you guys and find out what you have to say. Ready, Maddie?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's time
for your comments of the week. You can send them using typing exclamation point recap in the chat. Of course, the link is at the bottom of the page on our twitch.tv channel as well. Rules on the screen. Please, please be kind and, you know, follow them. That would be much appreciated. Who's kicking us off this particular week, Mr. Shades?
Well, since all our emails are pretty even, I'll go ahead and start us off here with this one here. We'll start with good old Tokumania. Tokumania won a while. Hey, guys! Tokumania here for episode 5 of Power Rangers Beast Morphers. It goes to show how Hasbro has proved they are doing a great job with the season thus far, because this was a pretty good Devin-focused episode. I know that father issues are cliche, but here it feels genuine. I also actually do like how he deals with consequences after losing his job, and it's not just easily resolved by the end of the episode. Ninja Steel! We're also introduced to the General of the Grid Battle Force, and Ben and Betty are his kids? Their antics were pretty funny in this episode too, but I find it very funny how almost everyone has parents except for Nate, which might be something to explore a lot more on his arc. What next? Are we going to meet Blaze and Roxy's parents and see how their current state affects them and give them a negative view on Grid Battle Force? Ha ha ha, like that'll ever happen. Also, a BJ Stag helmet prop. Doesn't seem too important, probably just an Easter egg. Hopefully capturing the Gigadrome will come back to bite them in the ass. I give this episode 5 out of 5. Also, actually, we forgot to mention the General. Because 9 times out of 10, when you get the General of like one of these kind of military deals, they're a total asshole, give no respect to the Rangers, don't listen to anything they have to say until they're proven that their plan is bupkis, and thus just give up. No. He has an idea he thinks can work. The Rangers agree and offer a follow-up idea that's actually even better, and he goes with it, and they play it out. He's not an asshole.
They're not playing everyone for fucking idiots.
Keep in mind, this guy also in Betty's little side project, so yeah. Take that with a grain of salt.
Well, proving that he's not an absolute fucking genius, but there's a brain in there.
Yeah,
he's not just an NPC.
He's pushing his kids, which, you know, parents, nepotism, whatever you want to call it. But he doesn't completely disown the Rangers either. That is normally the trope, where the General comes and thinks his kids are the best thing on God's green earth, and the Rangers are just idiots. No, he's like, no, you guys are doing all right. You know, you guys got a good idea. Let's run with it. Let's go for it. You know? And at the end of the episode, he's like, oh, all right, good job. I like what you guys did. Nicely done. So, yeah. Again, I'll take it. It's different. It's new. Now, I'm going to go ahead and 86 the questions, because it's just favorites. Favorite Ultraman theme, favorite Sentai ending theme, favorite Godzilla movie.
We're going to be here all day.
Yeah,
I'm starting to come to the point where I think questions might have to get axed, because we're just getting the same questions over and over again.
Go
ahead, dude.
That or just limit it to one question. One question, make it a good one.
Yeah.
Actually, John, there's another one we can hit on this. The other new one.
Ah, I know which one you're referring to.
Is this redundant?
I think that kind of sums it up. Nonetheless, still, thank you for the email, Tokumania. Nicely done, as always. Moving on from there, next up, we got Solar Star.
Solar Star here, and I have harped on secret identities before. What's the point when the villains know who they are? Perhaps it's not the villains, but the very people they protect. To quote Agent K from Men in Black, a person is smart, people are dumb, panicking, dangerous animals, and you know it. That's the Mega Rangers and the Lupin Rangers.
Ah, bingo! Right there.
Thank you. We have an employer that is all about hard work and doesn't tolerate slacking off no matter what, who your dad is. Those types are still out there, but nowadays an employer would just bend over backwards and cater to the whims of the mayor's kid out of fear of their continued employment. Okay. This episode's getting 4 Morphin Braces out of 5. I couldn't help but cringe at Ben and Betty's attempts at a cheap laugh all in front of their dad. Betty was lucky that the giant robot hand didn't break every bone in her body. We know, right?
Yeah, go to hell, physics.
I suppose comic relief characters in Power Rangers have more plot armor than Harry and Marv.
Oof.
Wow. But at least they reacted to pain. Oh, wow. That Home Alone reference. All right. If the Rangers are going to keep their identity secret, they need to be careful where they demorph, because you never know where there's someone hiding and they could whip out their smartphone. Solar Star? I think he might have called something.
Yeah, I'm getting the feeling that he's onto something here, because, yeah, it's
because
very clear.
The way the writing is and how intelligent the writing is, but without dumbing, but keeping it simple for the kids, but not playing too dumb for the rest of the audience, they can very well pull that off.
Yeah, it's very clear this isn't taking place in modern day, the age of smartphones. They could easily write that in as a plot point.
Smartphones are a thing in the universe, in this universe. So, yeah, Solar Star, you may have called the next an episode there.
Uh huh. We'll be watching for that. So we'll make a note of that.
Actually, you know what? How about we answer this question? I think it's a good one. What was the first Daikaiju movie you ever saw?
Ooh, yeah, that is a good one.
Ooh.
I'm trying to remember.
I know it was a Godzilla movie. I'm pretty sure that's all our answers.
Yeah, I think that was for sure. I just don't remember exactly which one.
I think it was the first one I reviewed, Godzilla versus Megalon. And that movie has not aged well.
No.
Yeah. I definitely remember it because I do remember it's the one I saw. I laughed as a kid when I saw Godzilla do that drop kick, that that sliding tail kick.
Hey, that is still a good drop kick, in fairness.
Yeah, but still, just looking at it today, you're just like, well, it's pretty laughable.
There's a little bit of cringe.
Yeah. So, for me.
A question needs to be answered. Do we count the Matthew Broderick movie as a Daikaiju?
Yeah, it has its problems, but technically Toho owns the rights, so technically Zilla is a Daikaiju. They only bought it just to kill it.
More than likely, because that would be the first Godzilla movie, which would make it the first Daikaiju movie I ever watched, or remember watching, I should say.
Yeah.
I'm in the same boat with you.
But if you have to keep it traditional, then it would be the MST3K riff of Godzilla versus Jet Jaguar. What was it, Megalon?
That was Megalon. Yeah, that was Jet Jaguar.
Yeah, there was a riff. So that I watched. So that was the first legit Godzilla movie I remember watching end to end.
Yeah,
it's silly, but it's fun to watch.
Yeah, I don't even remember which one it was. I know I've seen a Godzilla movie before. It was my first, but I don't remember which one. It's been so goddamn long.
I remember watching Godzilla marathons at a friend's house on the weekend. He had cable and I didn't, and we watched Godzilla movies all weekend. Godzilla versus Mothra, Godzilla versus the Cosmic Monster, aka Godzilla versus Mechagodzilla. That's the one with the 8 people who are disguised as humans. Don't ask.
Yeah.
A lot of those old badly dubbed movies was, and of course they were later on Monster Vision with Joe Bob. And then I saw them again. So.
And this is where being in quote unquote a small town in the sticks. Not as the sticks as easy would be, but hell, we didn't have as many channels in our basic cable package. We had the French channels, we had your basic channels, and the one or two sports channels. So we didn't have much, you know, until we moved up here. So we didn't have channels that would play Godzilla, but they would play the Godzilla movie, the Matthew Broderick movie. But so why so long?
Why? Because my MSCCK fandom would come up around 2009 to 2010 to give you an idea of when I started watching these movies legit. But because the way the channel distribution worked, or yeah, how you watched a movie on TV was you watched the French dub. And it's usually one of them Hollywood movies because, well, Hollywood movies. So badly dubbed or French, as in not French Canadian, but French French dub. So obviously the swears would be French French idiom. Yeah, there's a reason why I do not like French dub movies.
Makes sense.
Anyway.
Yeah, let's put it that way. Anyway, that's it for Solar Star. Short story long. Apologies. Next up is Zeltrax Millennium. By the way, how are you, bud? How you doing, bud? In the chat, how you doing, bud?
Hey, Zeltrax. Anyway, you know, with a title like Taking Care of Business, you'd think we'd have an homage to Aisha using the Megazord to smack Ivan Ooze in the nutsack from the original movie. Bummer.
That's another one we could have used.
Yeah. Good call.
You know what? To bring it back to modern times. Hey, Aisha, what are you doing? Pulling a Seth Rollins on Brock Lesnar.
Indeed. Anyway, oh my God. Actual good fucking drama in a Power Rangers episode? Take it away! But then give it back because I love this episode! There was a crap ton of original Zord footage in this episode, which I didn't think was even possible. Ben and Betty's antics just helped the team figure out how to possibly get the tech needed to combine the mechs together. And Hasbro, don't think we didn't see PJ Stagg's head on that dolly. Yeah, they all noticed on that one. They are either very good with the foreshadowing or they are laying it on real thick that Gold and Silver are coming up. You do feel for Devin how he wants to make his dad proud of him, but the Ranger duty screwed him over in getting on his good graces. I don't know what's worse, Mr. Collins when he berated and tried to use his son for money, or this. But yeah, it's episode 5 and there is still no bad episodes. Hasbro's keeping the momentum going with the show and I couldn't be more proud. Until they let go of Jason Bischoff, who was one of the best fandom links to the brand this side of the planet. Gah!
Yeah, we talked about that. Yeah. I'm still a little miffed at Hasbro. Hasbro, you were doing good till that.
Anyway, catch you guys later. I'm giving this an A. Abso-fucking-lutely. Anyway, that's it for Zeltrax. Next up is Red Rob.
Hey, Rap Recapper. Sorry I couldn't make it today on Twitch because I have a book I need to go to. But I'll be keeping you guys posted on how it did go. Now my results for taking care of business. And by the way, I will not say the G in there. I'm saying taking care of business, BTO. So that's my one reference. I guess this is good. Looks like any character has one parent, Ben and Betty's dad. Major Daniels is giving a hand to his son. Son is an awesome display. Mayor Daniels, Major. I read that as a J. Mayor Daniels is giving a hand to his son. Is an awesome display of father-son moment. There's nothing I can complain of than Devin losing his car wash job, yet made it the dilemma good for him as a Ranger. Sure, the boss is an asshole, even though I don't like those kinds of characters, but it works for its purpose of the episode. I have a strange hunch where I think Mayor Daniels knew Devin is a Ranger and Devin didn't know what his dad knew, which is kind of interesting. Maybe a little early for that, but if you want to count that pride thing as a. And that one scene of looking at that guy, that one look, as foreshadowing, you called it right then and there. I'd rate this episode 9 out of 10 clean cars. Well, that's it for me. Me and the power protect you. So, see ya. Next up, we have... we have Keith. Okay, sorry. I was looking at the thing. Okay, we have Keith.
Keith Inman up next. Hey, guys, sorry I haven't sent anything since the premiere. Lately, I've been rolling snake eyes on things to say and how to say them when it comes to the episodes, and hopefully I can properly get back into the swing of things here with tonight's podcast.
But sometimes being speechless is not a bad thing.
All right, give me a second. I'm responding to something in the chat real quick.
Ah.
Anyway, episodes 2 through 5 so far. These episodes have been a lot of fun to watch, but I'm still keeping my guard up because of the last time I let my guard down because of a good start during Dino Charge's run, I ended up getting burned hard by the finale to the second half of its series. Can't blame you there. Devin's father. This man as a character so far is a major improvement over the father characters from the last two seasons, and this week's episode helps me like him a little bit more in the acting department because I can feel the disappointment and hurt in his voice when he said, "Not as sorry as I am," to Devin. Ben and Betty.
Ow.
It's nice to have comic relief that are actually helpful in this franchise again. Whether it's saving Devin from a Tronic, sparking the idea of reverse engineering the enemy's tech for the Ranger's arsenal, or actually being somewhat effective hype men when it came to trying to promote the Morphex bikes. I also won't give them crap for the fear of bees and trying to quarantine them in the previous episode, because as someone who has been stung in the mouth by one when they were really young, I understand their fear. Question for all, which of these two tropes in Modern Sentai / Power Rangers are you guys sick of and feel like need to rest for a while? The idiot Reds or the multiple Zords?
The multiple Zords are not going away. Get used to it. That's just how you sell. That's just how Toei works nowadays. Collectible gimmicks or GTFO. I'm sorry, there's nothing you can do about that.
Honestly, this could be a case of the idiot Reds are
well, for all we know, we've had some pretty good ones. I mean, we've had two really good ones in the last Sentai. And the new one, in Ryusojuwa, we've only seen episode one, but so far he's a little headstrong, he's a little plucky, but he's not annoying. I wouldn't call him annoying yet. So,
yeah.
So you can limit the Zords. I mean, again, going back to Lupin, didn't have that many. It had a few, but they didn't pile them on. At least it wasn't 40 goddamn Kutama like the last show. Ugh. And yes, they had a bin full of Kutama, and no, I didn't find any good ones. Well, the 12 that matter anyway.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna let Shades type out the thing. He's taking care of business there. And actually, that's it. That's it for him. So we're gonna move on straight to our next one, which happens to be Adex Spider. Hey guys, it's ADAC with it could be a compliment, who knows, but it's it's ADAC with my comment of this episode. Let's jump right in. Mission debriefing start. So it looks like Devin has a job at a car wash and doesn't think he's taking this job very seriously. And it's probably because his dad wanted to see his son get a taste of the real world. Also, the way Devin wore the car wash. It's not like another character that's worn red and blue overalls. Oh, wait! Thank you, Adek. At least I'm the only one who noticed. Let's see. When Ravi and Zoe decide to help out, I couldn't help but play the car wash song.
We were all thinking it. Don't feel bad.
We were all thinking it. Bike scenes were pretty cool, and I thought when Slicertron, that's the name they went with, I did not hear, was going to throw his saws at the civilian, and Devin uses super speed to save her, I thought the saw was going to hit his visor, and his dad finding out that his son is the Red Ranger all along. Another thing you might have called right there.
Too early for that. I think
too
you're
early,
on the money.
But you might have called for later. Keep that. Yeah. Keep that ball.
Let's put a pin in that.
I'm pretty sure he's going to find out who the Rangers are, kind of like what happened with Wes and his father from Time Force. The rest of the episode was just great. My analysis is straight A. Hasbro, you're doing good so far. Don't fuck up now. Anyways, that's it for me. I blanked for a second. I'm sorry. That's it for A Deck.
Yeah. Also,
next up is Rachel Finn.
Also, real quick, the perfect button for the end of that email.
Don't fuck up.
Yeah. I was thinking that, and I was like, okay. I was distracted by Renico. After the Ranger stuff, ask away. Definitely. Next up, Ranger fan Nathan.
Indeed. Hey, fellas, since I'm sending this in on Thursday, I'll keep it short and sweet. I like the episode. I think that Beast Morphers has handled the father-son story arc the best of all the Ranger shows. I liked how Devin admitted that he has disappointed his father and doesn't want to keep doing it. I feel like we're going to get a Time Force type of reveal between Devin and his dad. Not
another call there.
Indeed. I thought the episode was good. I give it 3.5 out of 5. Keep it up, Beast Morphers. Quick question. Which Toku theme gives you goosebumps the moment you hear the music start?
Ooh.
That's a good question. The answer is yes.
Honestly, I'm not a goosebumps type of guy.
I got like 93 Toku themes to go through on my phone, so I'm going to have to abstain from that one.
Yeah, I'm not a goosebumps type of guy myself. I get goosebumps when I get cold, and that's about it. For me, I mean, when I first heard the Lupin Ranger versus Pato Ranger songs, all three, like the Pato Ranger song, the Lupin Ranger song, and then them smushed together, I was like, whoa, that's some genius in right there. So that's one example. Too early maybe, but it's a good example of what that for me that would be a goosebumps moment right there. There's another one in there, I think. I can't think of it right now.
I'm gonna say the Gaim theme.
That's fair.
Yeah, the Gaim theme. That's fair. Yeah. Those, yeah.
Yeah. I'll tell you when I do get goosebumps for a theme is when they insert it nostalgically into something. Like it's like when a writer comes back for a movie, not a movie war, fuck it, or a movie type, not for a Tyson film, but a movie war, you know, crossover, like Drive and Gaim, Gaim and Wizard, X-Aid and Drive. You know what I'm talking about. When they play the old theme or a versus Sentai movie, you know, it's like that, you know, it's moments like that where you get goosebumps.
Yeah, anything that they put a song in there, like another goosebumps moment, I guess, would be like when in the Power Rangers movie from a couple of years ago, they inserted the movie version of MMPR of the MMPR theme in there. That was like a mark out moment. That was like a, oh yeah,
indeed.
So that kind of stuff, obviously.
Anyway, that's pretty much it for Ranger fan Nathan. Let's wrap this up with our last email from Dragon Zeron.
Hey, I know we met that guy.
he looked like a couple times gentleman, actually. By the way,
yeah, we met him a couple times at Morphicon Express. He even interviewed me until his battery ran out, or was it his storage? Yep. So, pro tip, buddy, invest in a camcorder.
Actually, he mentions that it was so awesome meeting Easy Rider and Mike Shell, and I was able to get an interview with Easy for my channel, but I got cut off. So hopefully in the future, we can work on something. Power Morphicon Express was so much fun. I got a lot of great interviews with the Rangers. I met some friends I knew online through my karaoke or my tokusatsu, and then I met people who I knew. Distracted by many things here. He's met a lot of people who he's met online through either I cannot talk tonight, gentlemen. I don't know if you noticed.
Slow down, Maddie. It's not a race.
Take a deep breath.
I know.
Take a breath.
I'm good. I don't know what I'm saying. And I got to meet some friends who knew me online through my karaoke or my tokusatsu. And then I met people who knew who I was, which had me shocked. So I hope they bring another Ranger Con to the Texas.
We'll see. Probably not next year because they're doing the big one next year, but you never know.
There's also a chance I might try to save up some money to go to Ranger Stop at Powermorphicon in Cali to meet you guys, dude. Make your way to Ranger Stop. You might meet a Maddie, or might meet yourself a Maddie or a Shades, maybe even a Spade Ace.
And hell
yeah. Ranger Stop's your best bet to meet all of us.
All of us are going to be. In fact, we've actually got it on authority that we may even have a monk joining us.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see.
Anyway, that's Dragon Zeron's email. Ladies and gentlemen, those were your emails and comments of the week. And I said emails and comments.
You did it again,
John. You do it before. I'll Dave myself. You. Yeah.
Put a quarter in the jar, Maddie.
Indeed. That is our comments for the week this week, ladies and gentlemen. If you want to send yours in, the link is located down in the description below, or you can use !recap to send yours in. Remember the rules: opinions only, no news or full summaries. Toku questions only. We're gonna start bringing the restriction: one question per comment. No versus questions or expectations/wanna-sees. One comment per person. Keep your comments as brief as possible, around 350 words or less. And remember that all comments are due by the start of the live show, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time next Thursday. So don't be late. And you guys are usually pretty good about that, thankfully. But with that, that is going to do it for us here tonight on the Ranger Recap. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you indeed enjoyed tonight's show and you haven't done so already, make sure you give us a follow to keep up with all our streams and more. And if you can, subscribe to get access to our exclusive Twitch emotes, our VIP Discord channels, and our loyalty badges. No riddles, Evan. That's up to DL, but I know you said you sent some into him, but I guess he didn't use them. I'm sorry. That being said, if you want to know what's happening the rest of this week here in RVTV, make sure you... Hit !! Schedule to see our Google Doc. Though we do have one edition. Next Monday, I'm going to be doing a special edition and a special stream over on my channel, twitch.tv/theshadesAT, where because the plane is fueled up and loaded, ready to go, because we're going to take a trip to Fandom Paradise. That's right, folks. It's the AMV.org VCAs. The Viewer's Choice Awards have arrived. The winners have been announced, and I will be showcasing the winners next Monday, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, over on my channel. And the week after that, it'll be the return of the Shades Plays, where I just have one word for you. If you don't think you want to check this out, I just have one word for you. Objection! That's right. I'm going to be taking a crack at the Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney Trilogy. The first three games have been digitally remastered with redone artwork for all the characters. You don't want to miss out on that. It's going to be a lot of fun, so be sure to check that out the Monday after next. So with that said, and of course, don't forget to check out our merch store, !! Merch in the chat. We've got t-shirts, coffee mugs, and a couple other things for you guys to buy. So if you want to support us here on RVT, go ahead and buy one of those. Buy the shirt!
Buy the shirt!
Anyway, that is going to do it for us here tonight. I want to thank our guest, Mike Shell, for joining us here tonight.
Always a pleasure to join you guys.
And indeed, with that, Easy, do you have any car wash jokes for us?
Ooh.
No, but I got a saw joke.
Go for it.
Close enough.
So, yeah, that's going to do it for the Ranger Recap. Again, a huge shout out to Scott and everyone who worked at Power Morphicon Express. Please, guys, come back either next year or the year after that back to Pasadena. I will definitely come back. I know for sure Mike will come back. And we had a blast. Scott actually thanked me for showing up. I said, no, thank you for having me. So Scott's a really chill dude. I'm sure we'll see him again in Cali, if not sooner. But then again, anyway, I'm Easy Rider, reminding you that if your dreams turn to dust, vacuum. I thought that was funny. Oh, there we go. I thought it was funny. Did you guys hear the one about the dumb blonde who decided to go ice fishing? Well, she cut a hole in the ice, and then she heard a voice calling from on high. There are no fish in this sea. There are no fish in this water. She's spooked. She's scared, so she decides to find another place to cut a hole in the ice. She cuts another hole in the ice with a saw. Of course, what else are you going to use? Again, the voice from on high says, "There are no fish in here." Again, she's scared, so she moves to another place, cuts another hole in the ice with a saw. It's like, and again, she hears a voice from on high, "There are no fish in here." And she's like, "Are you God?" And the man on the intercom says, "No, ma'am, this is a hockey rink." I thought Maddie would get it. I'll throw in another. This is a dad joke. This is an oldie but a goodie. I've said this one before, but I'll say it again. Did you guys hear the one about the guy who's sitting alone at this bar, and this drunk old man comes up and he leans on the guy's shoulder and said, "I just had sex with your mom and she was great." The guy says nothing. Old man comes back again, even more drunk. It's like, "I just had sex with your mom, and she says she loved it." Guy again says nothing. Guy comes back again, even more soused to the gills, and he says, "Your mom's the best lay in town, and everyone knows it." He finally looks up and says, "Go home, Dad, you're drunk." I'm Easy Rider, reminding you that the fan sub will never die. We are your Ranger Recappers. We will see you next time. And as always, if you have a problem in life, hashtag just add Morphex. And as always, may the power protect you. We'll see you.
Thanks to my patrons like Voice for their donations. Pledge today so you can keep these streams going. Also, thanks to Easy's patrons, including Chris Lee, Chris Froles, Michael Antignano, Stephen Harris, Galen Hanna, Alonzo Tompkins, Anthony Guidman, Matthew Golem Long, Dino, and super shout out to Eric Vaughn and Shane Thompson for their support.
The original idea for this stinger was me singing Taking Care of Business by Bachman Turner Overdrive. Be thankful. I just want to write a parody of that song now. Be afraid. Be very afraid.